Chapter 1. Now the Sneech-Pats of Patriotville liked freedom a lot, but the Wunsters, who lived way up in Capitalville, did not. The Sneech-Pats loved free speech in all of its fashions. They engaged in debates. They wrote down their passions. They argued about the moon and if they could reach, and most called it a gift to be able to teach. Not all speech was nice. Some was altogether awful. But no matter the topic, all speech was lawful. If any of their speaking logic should become upended, no Sneech convinced any Sneech by being offended. The Sneech-Pats had been happy as far as most could keep track, because few recalled the Star War and how it all started way, way back. There were Sneeches without stars, and there were Sneeches with them, and differences upon their tummies were used to sow division. The star tummies felt that they were the best, and the plain-tummied Sneeches, well, you know the rest. Thus, the Sneech-Pat relatives you find in Patriotville today are simply the great-grandchildren of beach Sneeches once led astray. And for that very reason, in fact, the Sneeches who are now gone had worked hard to clean up their act and determined to move on. Sneech-Pat children were taught through an open education to respect divergent Sneech-Pat thought and use logic in argumentation. Sneech-Pats praised those with courage and belief. Even unpopular Sneech-Pats had every right to speak. So the Sneech-Pats spoke freely in every direction on issues ranging widely from kittens to elections.